Hot Diver Radio is sponsored by Dive Right.
This is the Tech Time with the illustrious Dr. Richard Vann.
Hello and welcome to another Dan Tech Time with Dr. Richard Vann. Dr. Vann, this week we're going to talk about HPNS, or high pressure nervous syndrome. I think a lot of tech divers are big fans of the movie The Abyss. And in The Abyss, these commercial oil workers were working on this underwater saturation habitat, and a big fear was getting HPNS, you know, the tremors or the shakes. So what is HPNS, and what depths does this become a factor at?
HPNS is the high pressure nervous syndrome. Now, it's interesting how the concept of HPNS developed, starting off from the notion of nitrogen narcosis. Clearly, it became clear after probably in the 1930s when Dr. Al Behnke of the U.S. Navy first proposed that nitrogen was a narcotic gas, and nitrogen narcosis could be abolished by breathing helium oxygen, that the concept arose that this high pressure nervous syndrome, or what they initially called helium tremors, because your hands would tremble, was related to helium itself. In other words, it was a property of helium, just as narcosis was a property of nitrogen. Well, after a number of decades of experimentation, including studies with liquid breathing animals, in which no gases at all needed to be respired, no inert gases like helium or nitrogen, it was discovered that it really wasn't not a property of helium itself. It was a property of pressure. And what appears to be going on is that the increase in pressure would actually distort the shape of some of the enzymes, the biochemical enzymes that make our reactions run properly, and as a result, things would not work as well, particularly neurological functioning of the body, and you'd get aspects of tremors and loss of appetite, poor sleeping, and very deep diving. You could even develop psychoses. And if you think of it in the opposite way, if you take some of these very deep sea fish that are brought up from thousands and thousands of feet, they have evolved for that pressure. And so when they're brought to the surface, the decrease in pressure distorts the way their enzymes are shaped too, and they won't function on the surface. So you can think of it that we're adapted to the absolute pressure that we live at, and obviously mm-hmm. we live at one atmosphere. So things just don't work as well when the absolute pressure increases highly as HPNS begins to be observed at around 600 feet, and probably the deepest that's possible for people to dive in a dry chamber is not much more than 2,000 feet. There's a lot of individual variation from one person to the next, but probably at around 3,000 feet, everybody will pretty much be unconscious as a result of HPNS. Now, there's another interesting aspect of it, that the narcosis that one gets from nitrogen, in some respects, counteracts the effects of pressure.
So I was going to ask you, like, how would you ameliorate this at, say, you're doing a commercial salvage at 800 feet and saturation dive?
Well, one way is to add a little bit of a narcotic gas, and this counteracts the effect of pressure. Not completely, but it does make it better. You could use nitrogen, and that was done in experiments by Dr. Peter Bennett at Duke back in the 1970s and 80s, and you can also use hydrogen. And the French did this with hydrogen because hydrogen is also a narcotic gas. It's not quite the potency that nitrogen has. And rather than being like a martini, it's more, I've heard, more like marijuana. But it does have the interesting property of breathing helium and hydrogen and nitrogen, excuse me, and oxygen, is also effective against HPNS. It has the added advantage of being a lighter gas.
Now, the question about hydrogen, what about explosions?
That's a real worry, and you have to be very, very careful. As it turns out, if you have less than 4% oxygen, then hydrogen and oxygen is not an explosive gas. So, in other words, you have to be quite deep, deeper than 1,000 feet or so.
So it's not based on the partial pressure of oxygen. It's based on the overall percentage.
No, it's based upon the partial pressure. And,
oh.
In other words, if you have the partial pressure is, and I can't remember exactly what the partial pressure at 4% at 1,000 feet is, but if it's less than a certain, maybe around 8% surface equivalent, the hydrogen will not burn.
Okay.
So you're safe. Now, when you blow off that hydrogen to the atmosphere, that's another issue, and you do have a fire hazard there. So they have to be very, very careful.
Okay. So HPNS is something when you're getting into like really deep diving or saturation diving, which is going to be a subject we're going to talk about in another tech time. But is this something that most technical divers have to worry about?
Most technical divers don't, unless they get deeper than around 600 feet. Now, there's another important factor regarding the incidence of HPNS, and that is the rate of descent. The faster you go, the more likely you are to develop HPNS. And, of course, there is no way that a technical diver can go down very slowly. Because these are bounce dives, they have to be very, very fast. As a consequence, they are more susceptible to HPNS than a saturation diver is, who can go down at a very leisurely pace and then just wait. And typically they could take days to get down to 1,500 feet and in some of the experimental work. So that the technical divers then are going to be more likely to develop HPNS than a saturation diver would be.
So you're saying if someone's doing like a really exploratory technical dive to say like 600 feet, since simply they're going so fast, bouncing down there because they're not going to be saturating, that will make them more prone to get HPNS.
That's absolutely right. That's absolutely right. And there have been reports of some of the very deep technical dives, and I'm thinking right now of Sheck Exley,
mm-hmm.
who on some of the dives that he made and returned successfully, he had reported symptoms of HPNS, and he chose to continue, and it's entirely possible that HPNS was one of the difficulties he faced on his last dive.
Wow. Okay. Well, Dr. Vann, thanks again.
You're quite welcome.
For more information about Pod Diver Radio and how to subscribe, go to our website at poddiver.org.
Scanner shows an underwater tunnel leading right into the...